השם ימכם. Tonight I would like to share with you a midrash from the Alkut Shimoni about Elkanah. Elkanah was one of the leaders of Am Yisrael. And the story is about that once a year he decided to go and visit in the Mishkan, the house of Hashem. And he did it with his whole entire family. And the Midrash said that once a year he decided to go through one of the cities in Israel. And he decided that he would like to sleep outside in the street of this city. Because many people saw a whole family sitting in the street and asked him, maybe we would like to be with us this night. And he said, no, we prefer to be outside in the city. And the people around say, where are you going? And he said, we are going once here to visit Hashem in the Mishkan. Would you like to join us? And the Midrash say that they were so excited from this, so we say, you know what? We would like to join your family and visit Hashem. And on the same way, they did it year after year. And every time they choose to go through different city. And in the first year, there were 5 families. And the second, there were 10 families. And slowly, slowly, it's become to be a whole event with so many people that all of them were so excited that they're going to visit the house of Hashem. In this way, Elkanah wants to make sure that Am Yisrael will be connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And he was insist to do it through visiting all the cities in Eretz Israel until thousands of people will join him to be part of this event, visiting the Mishkan. And the Elkut Shimoni ended this Midrash by saying that because of that, because it was so important for him to connect Am Yisrael to the source of Torah and mitzvot in the Mishkan, because of that, HaKadosh Baruch Hu bless him that his son Shmuel became to be the educator and the leader of Am Yisrael, and he was the one that educated thousands of people for Torah and mitzvot the generation and generation after that. And I'm telling you this Midrash because this brings to mind for me one of our best friends, Elio Spaz, who passed away a year ago, just the day after Shavuot. And he was Mekarev on the same way of Elkanah. I would like to share with you a little bit about Elios. Elios was born in Israel. His parents were very active in Bnei Akiva, South Africa, and made Aliyah and lived in Mitzpe Yericho. Elios educated in Israel. He was in the Yeshiva High School in Israel. And afterwards, he went to the army. He served as a combat soldier in the Nahal. He started to learn engineering, civil engineering. And just before he continued with his life, he decided to go on Shlichut to Germany. Because he heard that thousands of people immigrate for the former Soviet Union, instead of to make Aliyah to Israel in the beginning of the 90s and of the last century, they decided to move to Germany. And Elios understood that this is a very special opportunity. When people that came from the former Soviet Union with very, very lack connection to Judaism and the state of Israel, and now they move to Germany, we have a very small window of opportunity to connect them back to their Judaism and to Medinat Israel. And together with other shlichim, he established 20 new shlichim of Bnei Akiva. And that he did as a single. Afterwards, he came back after this year of shlichut. He met Noah, she was also shlicha, and they got married in Israel. A few years after, Elios became to be the head of the German desk at World Bnei Akiva. And one of his main projects was to establish and to found the Hachshara of Bnei Akiva, Germany. He started with 5 or 6 chevre, but Elios, on the same way of Elkanah, he went from a village to village, from community to community in Germany, and he told them, would you like to be connected to Torah mitzvot? Join me to our Hachshara. And by that, he established the first and the second Hachshara from Germany. Afterwards, when he established his family in Israel, he decided to go on a long shlichut with his family, with another two of his best friend's family, to go as a one delegation to Western Germany to establish new Sdifim of Bnei Akiva. And through 2 or 3 years, they managed to build 5 new Sdifim of Bnei Akiva. And to bring chevre for Shabbatonim and seminarim and achshara, and many, many of his chanichim made aliyah. Elkanah in his way, and Elios in his way, made sure that every Jew would be connected to Am Yisrael and to Eretz Yisrael. And I would like to ask you this evening to commemorate Elios, that his life was Chaim Shel Shlichut. Chaim Shel Shlichut Shelo Mevatrim Al Af Yehudi. In this opportunity, I would like to wish all of you and your family Chag Sameach, and Be'ezrat Hashem, have a meaningful learning this night. Leitraot.
אנחנו נמצאים במיכלשטאט, מיכלשטאט בקברו של הבעל שם, במקום מאוד מיוחד, השירותים. כדי לפתוח את השירותים, יש לנו פה הוראות הפעלה. Enter the Jewish year, צריך להכניס את השנה היהודית, אז אנחנו נכניס אותו עכשיו. הופה.
היה קליק.
היה קליק.
יש כוח, אליוס.
כאן, מגרמניה, הארץ עם ההיסטוריה הכל כך מדממת הזאת, הארץ שגורמת לרבים מכם בטח לזעזוע, רק לשמוע את השם, רק בטח אתם שואלים את עצמכם, איך אפשר לנסוע לגרמניה? אז כאן מהארץ הזאת, אני קורא לכם, אנחנו צריכים את העזרה שלכם. אנחנו צריכים עוד שליחים איכותיים. פה, צמאים לתורה, צמאים לשבת, צמאים ליהדות, צמאים לקשר בלתי אמצעי עם עם ישראל, עם ארץ ישראל, עם מדינת ישראל. אני צריך שליחים. אנחנו צריכים שתבואו, תייצגו פה את כל מה שטוב ויפה וחשוב ונכון בעם ישראל, בארץ ישראל, ביהדות. זה קשה, זה אני יודע את זה. לי זה קשה לפה בגרמניה, אבל זה חשוב ביותר. אני רוצה לברך בשם בני עקיבא גרמניה, את הנציגים שלנו שיושבים עכשיו בקהל, נציגים שהגיעו מקהילות שאנחנו נמצאים בהן ומקהילות שאנחנו לא נמצאים בהן, את הנציגים מדיסלדורף, מדורטמונד, מדויסבורג, מהקהילות של מדינת הסן, מאופנבך, מדאמשטאט, את הנציגים שהגיעו ממינכן, הנציג שהגיע מגלזן קירשן, כולכם אתם חלק ממאורע היסטורי. וידע שיש בנציגים מבני עקיבא גרמניה אחרי שמאז השואה דבר הזה לא קרה. בני עקיבא התחילה לפעול פה ותמשיך לפעול פה ותגדל ותצליח ותקרב ככל שתצטרך עד שיבוא לציון גואל, עד שכבר לא יזדקקו לנו בעזרת השם במהרה בימינו. בברכת חזקו חברים, בעזרת השם נעשה ונצליח, ובברכת בבניין הארץ, בבניין, בברכת עלייה ועשייה.